And so it begins, with just a small step of disobedience.
Oh, wait, that's the wrong introduction. I think that belongs to something else. Well, either way, it is time to finally come back to one of the most wondrous games that I have ever played, known as Minecraft. It has been quite a long time since I last properly sat down to play this game. Like, maybe, I don't know, 20 decades ago was the last time I played it. However, recently, as in last night, I was super bored, couldn't figure out what I wanted to play, and I was like, hey, you know what, how about I look down my Steam library, and I just can't decide anything, and I start doing that game hop thing, and I thought, you know what, it's been a while since I've played Minecraft completely, like, actually sat down, you know, not for longer than 2 minutes to play it, and I had to look online for a spot of some nostalgia trips, and I ended up searching up one of the YouTubers, which is one of the ones that when they were doing the Minecraft back then for the first time, they were one of the big ones, as far as I remember, and that was CNanners. Now, I had never actually completely watched his Welcome to Minecraft series back in the day. I think I only saw like one or two episodes total, way back in the day. But I was watching through him last night, and I think I got to like episode 9, maybe, or something like that. And it was so nostalgic. Personally, there was quite a few different YouTubers that I watched, but CNanners wasn't really the one that got me into the whole Minecraft thing. Armageddon X was the one that actually introduced me to Minecraft, and then it was other YouTubers like X's Adventures and stuff like that that ended up getting me further into the Minecraft craze. And I played it all the time back then. Like, that was the only game that existed for me back in the day. Minecraft was it. And I wanted to come back. However, not only has it been a long time since I actually played Minecraft, it's also been quite a long time since I actually recorded it. Just normal Minecraft. I was doing the Super Hostile map. I wouldn't say recently, but it was still recently enough. But season 4 of Minecraft, that lasted like 2 episodes or something like that, was supposed to be the one that would kick off and would last a while, but it never did. Of course. Right. Now, whether you want to see Minecraft or not back on the channel, I have gotten a few requests to bring more Minecraft back, and I'd be more than happy to. A lot of people will probably be disappointed because Minecraft is looked down upon. I don't look down upon it. There are some things that I don't like compared to, you know, older, which we'll talk about as I'm playing the game. Because I'm on such a nostalgia trip at the moment, we're going to be talking a lot about the past. But as I said, this isn't going to be any... we're not going to be playing alpha or anything. This is normal 1.8.9 Minecraft. 1.9 is not out yet. When it is, however, then we're going to have some nifty shit. Hopefully. But thankfully, I don't have to like go and create a new world or anything. If a new update comes out, it all sifts right in. It's gonna take me just a minute to wake up fully. I ended up falling asleep. I mean, because even though I got plenty of sleep, I went back to sleep for some reason, and I was woken up. Anyways, I'm here to do it. I'm ready. We're gonna play. We're gonna do this. We got plenty of freaking time to sit around and waste time on Minecraft. And thankfully, this, I can just see the damn time on the screen, because I don't play this game in the full screen mode. So I can just see everything. I can see everything, including the time. As when I'm in, like, a Steam game or whatever, I have to constantly stop and shift tab to look at the thing. Also, one other thing I wanted to note is, has every YouTuber just switched into the same thing these days? Is there a single YouTuber that doesn't upload their videos where the title is completely just capital letters? Has anybody else noticed that? Like, I've watched a lot of these YouTubers, and I knew that they did the capital letter thing, but I never really realized that they do it, and everyone does it all the time. I never noticed that until now. What the hell is up with capital letters? And why do you have to do them? Whatever. Oh, yeah, one thing, I did load this up earlier, and I loaded up a creative world, and then I deleted it. I was just kind of dorking around. And I noticed that the soundtrack, the updated soundtrack, because I haven't really played too much of this since some of the latest updates, you know, 5 months ago. And I never noticed that the updated soundtracks are actually fantastic. Like, see, that is fantastic. The old ones will always hold that nostalgic part, but I think I like the remastered ones still, or two. We do have a texture pack installed. It is a resource pack. It is the Old Faithful pack, or just Faithful, 32x32. It's basically, if you don't know what it is, it's basically just the default texture pack upgraded into 32x32. So it's faithful to the normal game. I also have Pure BD Craft, which is what I used to always use by Sfax, but along with 3D blocks and 3D items, but I'll just stick with Old Faithful for now. I'm going to keep calling it Old Faithful because that's what the original Faithful pack was called, was Old Faithful. Anyways, single player. Oh, look, there's Super Hostile. We're going to create a new world. I'm just going to call it Survival. I'm going to call it what I used to always call them, Survival Let's Play. We're going to keep it on game mode Survival. World options, allow cheats are off. Default world type, I don't want to mess around with that. I would, like, try to change some of... Like, see, one of the cool things that I saw that you can do now is you can customize, and you can literally do everything. Change absolutely everything, which, I mean, I kind of want to... See, now that I'm looking at it, I really want to... Like, see, I can take the dungeons and make dungeon count 100. We'll increase that to 10. How about just increasing dungeon counts to 10? I don't know what 10 means. Is that like 10 every chunk? I don't know. But everything else is here, and you go to next page. You can just change everything. Yeah, gravel, granite. But I'm not gonna worry too much about this stuff. See, I could change coal, or I could make all this stuff a little more rare, but. Like spawn tries, as far as I know, to make it rare, you have to lower the spawn tries, I think. But I don't want to mess around because I don't want to accidentally fuck something up. So we'll go with customized for now. And yes, I do want a bonus chest on. I know, okay, I know it makes it a little easier, but I like the bonus chest because otherwise it's just the same thing. Make the same exact shit every second, or every start of the world. You're always getting those couple pieces of wood and making the same damn tool over and over again. You know, that kind of, and I know most of the game is repetitive anyways, at least when you're doing the digging part, but I don't know, I just like the bonus chest to see what kind of shit that you can get. Done, and this is going to be on hard difficulty as well. I want to give myself a challenge. Old world, or loading world. Alright, let's get a good world. I think the game broke. No, game did not break. We spawned on sand! That is perfect freaking nostalgia! Let's mark our territory here. I'm just gonna... oh god, the sensitivity is not what I'm used to. To mark the territory, I'm just gonna plop, plop, and then plop. Oh yes, and by the way, one other thing I wanted to say is that, this is just going to be that side Let's Play that I'm going to be doing. I know I've still got the other shit to get to, I know, just please, I don't know. This is just gonna be a side thing that I'll just continuously do, until I don't. I'm very happy, though, that we spawned on sand. That is very nostalgic, because back in the day, and just in case you never played Minecraft way back in the day, or maybe if you did, and this will help your nostalgia boner go as well, back in the day, you only spawned on sand, and that was it. You only spawned on sand. So that was a nice rush of adrenaline. All right, so let's see what we get inside of our chest. Oh, we get some of a new type of wood that I've never really played with. A stick, some wood... Or planks. Ooh, nice. 6 apples and a stoner boner axe, which is actually a good starting tool. And we also get some of this shit. And I'm going to break this with my hand. Or torch, rather. And I'll organize that as time goes on. Let's go to options. We're going to flip it to hard, and we're going to lock it. Yes, now we can't change it. No cheating. All right, so we got an ocean. Oh, I'm already loving this. This is reminding me. Oh, look at this. We got a hill. Now, one other thing is I kind of want to live next to mountains or hill sort of thing like this. Because that's what I used to always do. And that's kind of my favorite areas to sit. So let's start getting some wood. I'm not going to collect too much because I want to actually do a little live exploring. Now, my draw distance is quite far, quite long. It's not too far, but that should help us find a suitable living area such as, like I said, any mountains or big hills. And this one would be nice because it's next to my spawn point, but I kind of want something a little bigger. Because I had loaded up... now this... okay, this totally goes against what I said before, but back in like September, I think September and October, I actually did load up Minecraft, but it was the Alpha 1.2.9 or whatever, the latest version of Alpha, to play, and I had created myself a nice base, and I actually have some video footage of it as well. In fact, that world still exists if I load up Alpha again. And I had basically gone to this mountain and was changing the entire thing into my base. It was all hollowed out, and oh, it was great. So I would like to do the same sort of thing. That's always been a dream of mine, to hollow out a mountain and turn it into one big base. So we've got some sheep here. I don't have any. I don't have any shit. Ooh. Now there are multiple things that I have never seen before that are new to Minecraft. Some things that I have seen but never really dabbled in, like new biomes. One of them is that Red Mesa biome or whatever. I've never even seen that before. I've heard of it, but I've never actually seen it in-game. There's also that biome over there, which I think is like the Plains biome or whatever, or the Savannah biome, and that's where this wood here comes from, but I've never actually really dabbled too much in that biome before. I just want to keep moving because I know shit's pretty hard on... hard difficulty. If things look choppy, it's because it's Minecraft and it's loading shit. Rose bushes. I miss the old rose. I don't know why they replaced it with a poppy. That was such a bad idea. Ooh, a cave. Okay, let's be very careful. Okay, it's absolutely nothing. Now, I already put these torches down, so I cannot put them back up. That is a rule of mine. Put the torch down in the cave. I'm not going to go back and pick it up. I always hated that, because I had played with some people that would do the same thing. But if we're in caves and there's a dead end, don't take the fucking torches out, because that's just going to trick me into thinking, oh, look, there's a part we missed. And then I go in there, and then it's, oh, yeah, wait. That's a place we've already been. I'm probably going to be walking quite far. We might be traveling for a while. We might even have to go into a small hidey hole for a night and do some digging or something, because I really want to find a nice area. It's not midday just yet, so we still have plenty of time. Plenty of time. So far, it just looks like we got the basic foresty biome. Birch trees. Oh, yes, there's also apparently a birch forest. There's actually a lot of biomes that I have never seen. Like, there's tall forests, like tall birch forests or something, some crap like that. But I don't think I've ever really even seen a birch forest. Ooh, yes, I love that. I love spruce wood. And so we've got, looks like a barren, almost completely barren snowy biome here with floating snow. I don't want to travel into a snow biome. There never seems to be really that many mountains. At least as far as I can remember. Oh, shit. Looks like the snow biome's starting to surround our shit. Yeah, shut up. Ah, there's another cave down there. Now, the reason I'm... Now, this actually looks like a neat area to set up, but I don't want to. That cave there might be useful. Another thing that I really like about Minecraft, that when you record it and just do basic survival, is because it's shit you don't see anymore. You just don't see this kind of stuff. And I love to get far in a world and have... Holy shit. Hello? What the hell is happening? What the hell happened there? And why am I walking slow? Maybe I wasn't walking slow. Anyways, I like to have it documented so that it's always here. I can always come back and watch, and when in the future, when I've got like really, really freaking massive base, I can look back and say, oh, this is how it all started. Oh, I remember when that forest was there, and now it's not because I deforest everything. Oh God, what the hell is up with these lag issues? Oh, I need more wood. Damn it. All right, let's get ourselves some coal. I think it's just still trying to load the world. Now, I heard that there's actually two from coming in the upcoming update, which has been in the works for too long, way too long. And that's another thing that that's pretty much one of the biggest things I don't like about modern Minecraft, and that's, well, back in the day, oh, for fuck's sake, what the hell? Back in the day, we got a new update pretty much almost every Friday, right? For like 2 years straight, or some crap like that. There was new shit out every time. You know, it would never really take that long to get an update out. Nowadays, it's like 5 to 12 months before we ever get any tiny bit of content. To be honest, 1.9 does look to be a big update, but it's been so long. It's been like 5 months since the last update, and the last update wasn't even a content update. It was just a bug fixes and all that crap. You know, so where the hell is our update? Like, if Notch was still in control. Okay, this is starting to really get on my nerves. Why the hell is it doing this? And it's not even just like, oh, for fuck. Oh God, I'm moving in like a slow motion again. What the hell is this? I've never experienced this before. Oh, I see what might be a mountain in the distance and something way out there. Maybe I should drop my draw distance down a little bit. I didn't think it was that long. I've got a Well, apparently it is, because everything wants to keep freezing. Like, there, for fuck's sake, I'm just in the bloody options screen and it can't even slow down. 20 chunks. Let's drop it down to 15 chunks. Will that help? I don't want to say it has so far. But anyways, as I was saying, oh. As I was saying, yeah, back in the day, we got so much content to Minecraft so often, and now it's so little that you know what I mean. But like I said, 1.9 does look to be quite a big update, and we got dual wielding on the way, and there's also two new enchantments that you can find, like mending, so that your tools will repair when you gather XP, like that kind of crap sounds awesome. Now these mountains I see don't really look like the mountains I wanted. I want the big dirt mountains from the original. I think they're still. I think you can still find the big, you know, dirt and stone, not just completely stone. I'm gonna collect these. These will be useful. Yeah, it doesn't seem like we've got too much of the glitching or the lagging. I think it must have been like the thing was way too high, which. It's kind of weird because I never had that problem before. Could be because I'm recording as well. Bandicam does also require quite a few resources. I mean, this place looks nice, but then again, it's not even really the tall. Uh-oh, the sun's going down. It's not really even the tall mountains that I want. I mean, it's kind of a mountain-ish, but I'm looking for the extreme hills biome, which is basically where the mountains are like whoosh, way the fuck up. But this is where we are going to have to take shelter. Like, we have to take shelter right now. All right, see, there was just a little bit of lag. That's fine. I don't want to take shelter in a cave at the moment. Let's just dig in here. And I've got some coal. I can make some torches. Make some torches. My skin is blue star, by the way. Because blue star. Just gonna stick a torch there. And let's start diggy-digging in quick. Yeah, another one of the YouTubers that really kicked off for me back in the day was the Yogscast. And then sadly, for some reason, I stopped watching them recently. It wasn't because I got sick of their content or anything. It was just, I think, well, what really happened is I kind of lost interest when they started doing the ridiculously childish thumbnails. Like, that's literally when I actually started losing interest. If anybody else followed the Yogscast, like the Lewis and Simon channel, the main channel, and do you remember back, it wasn't that long ago, but it was still quite a while ago, when they started doing the different types of thumbnails, and they were just the childish, cutesy thumbnails, and I just didn't like that. I absolutely hated it, and they're still doing it to this day. And I just haven't watched much of them because of it. And it's nothing to do with their content, really. I mean, their content is a lot different than it used to be, but I don't know. We can make 3 mushroom soups. And mushroom soups, because I really have to worry about survival here, mushroom soup is really kind of a thing. I never made too much, which is why I instantly forgot that you make 4 bowls. All right. And does this stuff stack? No. I had to turn away and sneeze. We managed to get a seed. A seed. A seed. Now before I forget, I want to make a stone pickaxe. In fact, we're going to make 2 of them. Oh, and I should probably make a sword as well. Now, I know that you can do the draggy thing, but you're probably going to see me most of the time not. I mean, I'm just so used to the old, where there was no draggy. Alright. I'm just going to do a little digging down a little further. Not too far, just a little bit. Maybe look for some iron. Iron, more coal, and I mean the stone is all nice as well. Though I prefer the original cobblestone texture, which had more black in it. The faithful actually kind of makes it look a little better than the default Minecraft texture is now. Yeah, I know this probably isn't effective mining, but oh well. It's been a long time since I've actually done any mining. It just feels good to be back to digging rocks. Alright, let's get all my shit. No, I can't handle that. That's how I do it in Terraria, but it's different in this game. Oh, that feels so much faster. It feels, holy shit, that's like, wow. Alright, I never thought I'd be saying the stone tool. Although back in the day, stone was really the shit that I only used for mining. I'm sure a lot of other people were the same way. Like, if I found iron, which was back in the day seemed so much harder to find, but most of my inventory was always full of stone tools, like stone pickaxes, and I would rarely ever use iron pickaxes to just do normal digging. And in this, out the start, you probably use more stone tools than anything, but then you start just finding infinite supplies of iron, and that's the only thing you start using. I usually, at least when I last played, I start playing with iron tools only when I have about a stack or around a stack of iron, but usually when you come through a cave, even a small cave, you end up coming out with at least half a stack, and if it's a big cave, you come out with like multiple stacks of iron or some shit. I wonder how long it's going to take us to find our first diamond. I'll probably, though I would squee more if I found diamond in the alpha, I'd probably still squee now, because it's been so long since I actually successfully found a diamond. And I've always been a sucker for vanilla survival in Minecraft. Like, you see, I mean, I love some of the mod packs, and I love a lot of the different mini games people have created, but like I said earlier, when you just don't see anybody do this kind of stuff anymore, like, this was the shit back in the day, just doing vanilla survival in Minecraft. But nowadays, personally, you never ever see that. At least I don't. And the only thing I do see is, the people playing with, the people with the intros that are just dubstep or something, and they're just doing these mini games or crap like that, or tutorials, which is fine, but you never see any of the vanilla stuff anymore like this, and it's probably because people lost interest in vanilla shit. I certainly have not, though I can still play the mini games, which I never have before. I'm talking about like the multiplayer server shit. Which some of it takes a lot of work and actually looks fantastic. Like I said, where it really sits for me is in the survival-y section. So we've almost gone through our first stone pickaxe. I'm trying not to dig down too far. I should be. I mean, because iron spawns quite high. I might just not be finding any of it. And I've got a new supply of coal. I've got to watch my hunger because, if I remember correctly, in hard you can starve to death. Gotta remember that there's new sounds to the game. Like this is a new digging sound. These are some of the different types of blocks you've already seen. I think you've actually seen all three of them now. These are new blocks that were added. I'm not exactly sure what one this one is. There's a white one. Oh, I think this one's andesite. Then the white one is like diorite. And then the orange one is granite. And they're just there for decorations. They don't do anything special. But it's just another thing for me to organize when I get my organization chess up. Now, I have been watching some people on YouTube recently, Minecraft related, like Grian. I don't think that's his actual name. I think it is. But if anybody else has seen him, he's basically someone who does a lot of building shit, and he's actually really good at it. I'm shit at building things in Minecraft. Like, my crap looks like ass. But I've been trying to watch some of his tutorial videos, and I loaded up that creative world that I was talking about earlier just to specifically try and build something, but I failed so hard. I'm gonna try some different trial and error things when we actually go to start building in this, but it's probably gonna turn out like shit anyways. But, trial and error is where it all sits at. Yeah, we got some zombies upstairs. Though they're kind of annoying, if they stay there, we'll be able to know when it's daytime because they'll burn to death. To death. Wonder if we'll ever come back here. Oh god, my inventory's gonna fill up with cobblestone. I'm surprised I haven't found any more ore. Like, holy shit. Oh, fuck. Okay, well, I did what I could. With what I had. Hope this is lit up enough. I didn't realize I dug down that far. Oh yeah, it's all blue out there. Forgot I did that. So we're gonna build another stone pickaxe. I'm not gonna turn this into planks yet, although I probably could. Well, I mean, there's nothing else that we can really do right now. I'm not equipped enough to go outside at night. Although I kind of want to peek my head out and maybe get a few kills. The XP would be nice. Though, I mean, getting XP this early on isn't as good as getting it later on. Because you could lose it easier now than you could gathering it later. And I just know I'm gonna collect like 50 levels and then be so pissed off when I die. That always would happen to me in the past. And I didn't play on hard in the past either. In fact, I've rarely ever played on hard at all, so I'm not gonna be used to it. I hope the skeletons aren't as OP as they used to be. I know they aren't as OP as they used to be in 1.5. Holy fuck, that was just annoying as shit. But now, I'm not sure about now. Is it daytime already? Well, it is. All right, let's gather up our workbench and let's be very cautious when we leave this place. I do that because I don't know if a creeper's there. I've learned the hard way back in the day. Okay, we got some spiders here. Now, I do want to kill these guys. Alright, nice. He didn't drop anything. I want a bow and arrow. I can hear lava. There's lava under the ground here. That's kind of neat. No, there's no opening either. Wow, it's literally just enclosed here. Now, I don't know if I want to collect some of this coal, because these places are famous for just having coal just plastered everywhere. Now, there's a cave here, but I don't want to go in it yet. We need to find a suitable living area, because at some point my inventory is going to full up, especially if I find a cave. Now, I'm going over here because I see that shit, whatever the hell it's called. I forgot what it's called. Sugarcane now. Oh, I remember back in the day when they just couldn't decide what to call these things. Like, the wiki kept changing. Like, they were called reeds, papyrus, bamboo, and then they finally settled on sugarcane. I think the same was with gunpowder. It used to be called sulfur, I think. Oh, thank fuck. I think it used to be called sulfur, didn't it? Or there was something significant it was called that wasn't gunpowder. Or maybe it's called sulfur now. Oh, of course I don't know. One piece of iron. That's fantastic. Oh, God. Even though this music is remastered, it still is so... What's the word? Nostalgic. Because I can remember. I can relate. Oh. It actually almost brings me back to my first multiplayer servers. I almost remember my first experiences with servers like the back of my hand. I could sit here and tell you stories about the servers, but the thing is while you might be able to visualize it in your own brain, it's not going to look anything like how I remember it. I just can't explain it like that. I wish I had video footage of it, and hopefully I can, like, open up my brain someday and look into it and look back at the memories, and you can, like, actually physically see my original servers. Oh, they were the shit back in the day. If I'm not going to collect any more coal, but if I see any iron, then I'm going to go for those. Now, we're going to... Oh, God, we're walking so far away from our original spawn point that it's probably going to get to the point where I'm not going to remember how to get back. I kind of do. Okay, now here we got a bunny. And I know that that's one of the new mobs, a mob I've never really messed around too much with. Hello, little bunny rabbits. Oh, what the hell is that? Oh, that's dirt. Dirt and granite next to each other. And that over there would be the white, which I think is the andesite. Diorite, I mean. Okay, we got more forest off that direction. I'm just trying to stay clear. The reason I was coming over this way is because I was trying to stay clear of the white snowy zone. Oh, shit, I want those pumpkins. Bloody hell. I know you can make pumpkin pie, but I don't know the recipes. I want to... I'm going to grab the pumpkin because I'm worried that I'm going to regret not grabbing it. And we're not doing that. We're not having that lag and slowdown thing. So I'd assume that apparently my thing was too high. Maybe I don't have enough memory, I guess. I mean, I paused the recording there when it was doing that to check my statuses. And my memory was being used a lot. I mean, like, holy shit. I can have so many things going and Minecraft just beats everything. I don't know how Minecraft requires so much fucking memory. But that must have been what was causing it. Alright, now I know pumpkins you can also wear on your face to make Enderman not pissed off. Which I never knew that. I'm gonna go ahead and eat an apple or two. I'm not gonna fill up my health just yet, but I'm going to go ahead and do that so that we don't get... Because we were on one hunger there. I don't want to drop too low. We're just finding these basic stone ones. I want the big grassy ones. The ones that you had back in the day. I know you can still find them. At least I hope you can. If you can't, then we're going to be searching for a long time and not finding anything. Oh boy, it looks like we got plains off to the left, which I'm sure... Oh shit, I can see trees in the distance on a big mountain-looking thing. Could that be our destination of choice? Oh, this actually looks like a nice hilly zone anyways. I thought it was going to be all plains. I heard a noise. I didn't recognize it. Boy, you're a scary looking one. You're a scary looking mob to begin with. What the hell is it? He's pooping. Of course. All little fuzzy things poop. There's more pumpkins here. Now, it's not exactly the mountain that I was wanting, but it's still a lot better than what we saw before, because this one isn't completely just stone, and there's a tree on it, and there was a floating bush there or something.